Welcome to our tutorial on time intelligence calculations and their visualization using Power BI dashboard. Time intelligence calculations include time series, time bucketing, year-on-year comparison, moving averages, and year-to-date analysis. Today we will try to cover each of these in our tutorial. So let's start our video. We have this spreadsheet of 2 years' sales of classic cars. There are two tables, sales and products. Product table contains list of all products. Let's import these tables into Power BI Desktop using Get Data feature. Open the Classic Cars Excel file in Power BI Desktop and then select both tables from the Navigator window. And click on the Load button to load the data into the data pane. Wait for the data to be loaded into the data pane. Now, you have both tables and their fields in the data pane, which you can use for visualization. Let's add an appropriate title to our dashboard using text box visual. We can add borders and rounded corners for better appearance. In time intelligence, the basic analysis we can perform is time bucketing. We can display sales of year 2022 and 2023 on a pie chart. We can also display all quarters of 2023 on another pie chart. We will use the same date field, but we will remove year from hierarchy, leaving quarters to appear on pie chart. We can add the year field from date hierarchy to the filters area and display only 2023 in the pie chart. Now we have created time buckets based on years and quarters. This is an effective way of comparing performance with previous periods. We can also compare sales of 2 years using line chart, and for that we need to go to the query editor. Here we will duplicate the sales table and rename it to revenue. Now, we will create another column named year, extracting year from the date column. We can use the date.year function for that. Click OK button to create the column. Now we will pivot the year column to display revenue on 2022 and 2023 in separate columns. Now we have both 2022 and 2023 columns to compare in our dashboard. We will not use this units sold column, so we can remove it from here. Now, let's click on the Close and Apply button to add this table to the data pane. The revenue table we added is right here in the data pane. To compare 2 years, we will add a line chart to our dashboard. We will add the date field to the x-axis. And both 2022 and 2023 fields to the y-axis. Then we will remove year, quarter, and day from the date hierarchy, leaving only months to compare 2 years by months. You can also use quarters or days instead of, or in addition to months, depending on your requirement. We can also display moving averages of 2023, which is another useful time intelligence visual. We will use the existing line chart and remove 2022 field from the y-axis, keeping only 2023 data. Then we will add a visual calculation using the moving average function. Visual calculations are very handy. Here you can directly add a new line without altering the table itself. We will use the 2023 data to calculate moving average for up to 6 months, which you can change as per your requirements. And here is our moving average line. We can change the field name to moving average. Although there are many other time intelligent visuals you can add, but we will add cumulative revenue or YTD revenue in our final visual. For that, we need to go to the table view and add a new custom column to our revenue table. We will select the revenue table here, and then we will click on the new column button to add a new column. Now we will use the calculate function to calculate the year-to-date totals of revenue. We need to expand the formula bar to make it easier for us to type the function. We will use the sum function on 2023 as expression in the calculate function. This will sum the amounts from the 2023 column based on criteria we will define in the next parameter. In the next parameter, we will use the filter function. This function will define how to calculate the sum of 2023 column. In the filter function, first we will select all data from the revenue table. Then, we will select the data based on current and previous dates. We will select all data where date is lower than or equal to the current date. We will use the earlier function to get the current date, meaning the date in the current row. So we will take the sum of all values from 2023 column, where values in date column are less than or equal to the value in date column in current row. Now we will click on the apply button to add this column to our revenue table. We should also format our numbers for better readability. We can duplicate one of these line charts to create a new one for the YTD analysis. We will remove the 2022 and 2023 data from the chart and add the newly created YTD field to the Y-axis of this line chart. Now that we have our final visual as well, we can work on the appearance of our dashboard. We can add visual borders and rounded corners to make our visual prettier and arrange them in symmetrical order. We also need to add a slicer to filter data on this dashboard based on products and product categories. We will add product category and product field to the slicer. We will change the slicer to drop down and place it on the top of the screen, right next to the title. This part of our report is now complete. In this dashboard, we displayed the revenue information using time intelligence calculations such as time bucketing, time series, moving average, year to date. We can create similar dashboard for units sold. In fact, we can duplicate this dashboard and modify it to display the units sold data in exactly the same way. We can rename this dashboard to revenue and then create a duplicate of this dashboard and call the other one units sold. So, in first step, we will create a table from the sales table, where we will create a year column and then pivot the year column into 2022 and 2023, just like the way we created the revenue table. First, we will replace the revenue field from both pie charts with the units sold field from the sales table to display the units sold data instead of revenue data. Then we will replace all fields in this line chart from revenue table with the fields from units sold table. Just the way we did before, we will duplicate the line chart with 2 years comparison and remove the 2022 information. Then we will create a new visual calculation to calculate 6-month moving average. And now we have 6-month moving average for units sold as well. For the YTD, we will copy the same formula from revenue table we created earlier and paste it in the new column in units sold table. Then we will simply replace the revenue table with the units sold table in the formula. Since both tables have exactly same structure, the formula should work perfectly fine. Now we can apply this to our visual. We can replace all fields from the YTD visual with those from the units sold table. And our YTD line for units sold during the year has been created. We must also format data in units sold table for better readability. Now it is much better, and with this our report is now complete. Thanks for watching our tutorial, and we hope you enjoyed it as well. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe as well. See you in the next tutorial.